When you select an artwork in Illustrator and then go to an effect and apply it, like this zigzag effect, then most of the time immediately you see something happening on the artboard. But the same is not true for two effects. So when you apply effect, path, outline object or outline stroke, you most of the time don't see anything happening. Why that? Welcome to this quick tip about outline stroke. And this quick tip might not be as short as you would think when seeing a quick tip, but let's just dive in. So when I select this path and then apply effect, path, outline stroke, then you see, well, nothing happens. And also when going into outline mode, then you see it's still just a path. So why would you want to use that effect? Now, those two effects cannot be used without the appearance panel. And if you don't know how to use it or how to read it, then I have a video about that as well. And I will link it in the information about this video. So let's take a look at this. I'm going to select this path again, and there we have it in the appearance panel, and you see there is outline stroke. It has been applied at the bottom. That is because it's only effective when it's applied after the stroke, and the effects are applied from top to bottom. So you first get a stroke, and then there is outline stroke. So that's how this works. And maybe you want to have multiple effects or maybe even multiple strokes on an object. And that's why I always prefer to put them into the stroke. And you can just put it in here. And outline stroke is what I call an in-between effect. So you have to use it in order to make something else work. In this case, what I want to do is make this look like it's somewhat rough. So it's been drawn manually. And in order to achieve that, let's go in here again because I want to apply the next effect to the stroke as well. I go to Effect, Distort and Transform and select Roughen, like so. And you see, well, that's how roughen usually works. That's how a roughened stroke looks. That is because currently it has been applied before outline stroke. And you can change that. You can just drag it below outline stroke. And then this looks differently. You see, this looks like roughen had been applied to a shape. And the shape is there because of outline stroke. Outline stroke is the same as if you would apply object path outline stroke. But when using it as an effect, you still have the comfort of editing this really nicely. So you can just edit that path, but still you can have the roughened effect. And let's go into this. It's too strong. Let's adjust this size, make it smaller, like so. And this looks like it's been handmade. We can also make it smooth, like so. And you see, that's what I wanted. Now let's take a look at this one. So this has the zigzag effect applied, and let's add outline stroke to this, effect, path, outline stroke. And again, it needs to be before zigzag. And you see, there's no effect in this. And that's because outline stroke is somewhat different. Usually you can drag effects around in the appearance panel, but to change their order and the order in which they get applied, but outline stroke is somewhat different. It's always best to actually apply it first. So let's first apply outline stroke, like so, and let's then go into effect and apply the zigzag, like so. And again, we need to drag that below outline stroke, and then you see it has a nice effect on this, but outline stroke needs to be selected first for some reason. There's another thing about outline stroke. So let's have a path again. And maybe I want to outline this. I want to put a black outline around it. And that can be done in hierarchical levels. So I can group that and then add another stroke on it. But first, again, I need to apply outline stroke. So let's just do that. And now I can group it. And you see in the layers panel that we now have the path, which has outline stroke. And then we've got one level on top of it, the group. And I can apply a stroke to the group as well. And that now goes around it. It also has the other stroke on the actual path, but we can hide that by just moving the stroke below the contents. And there we have our outline along that path. And still, we can select that and move it around. So those are use cases for the outline stroke effect.